Hello everyone, Shikha is here once again. Today we are here to discuss about the prescribed poem of 10th standard by CBSC, A Tiger in the Zoo. So here is a little introduction about the poet of this poem, George Leslie Norris. Norris has written this poem. Leslie Norris was a prize-winning Welsh poet and short story writer. He taught at academic institutions in Britain and the United States, including Brigham Young University. He was born on 21st May 1921 and he died on 6 April 2006. So before summarization of this poem, here comes an introduction of this poem. The poem written by Leslie Norris explains the agony and helplessness of a caged tiger. How a tiger is so helpless whenever he is caged, and where he is caged in a zoo. The poet explains what his life would be if he had been a free animal. The poet has tried to explain about the condition of animals that are caged by human beings for their own fun. So now we begin to summarize this poem. The poem begins with a description of a tiger that is very beautiful and is walking in his little cage. Here you see in the first stanza, what has been given in your book. He stalks in his vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage, on pads of velvet white, in his white rage. Yes, in this stanza, the poet describes the appearance of the tiger. The tiger has beautiful stripes on his skin and has velvet-like soft paws. In the last two lines, the poet described the gesture of the tiger. The tiger is not happy and is quite angry because he is being confined in the cage. The poet says that if the tiger was not confined to the zoo cage, he would have been hiding himself behind the long grass near some water body. Here, in second extract you see, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. So, if he was not confined, then he would have been hiding himself near about any water body. For what? For catching its prey, that is the deer. Also, he would have terrorized the residents of the villages around the forest area. In next extract, you see that he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, bearing his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. So, he would have been terrorized if he was not confined in the cage. But the reality is totally opposite. Now he is confined in the cage. That cage which was made up of a strong building material, and he was helpless there. He couldn't show his power to the visitors. As you know, the tiger is considered as the most powerful animal of the forest. But being confined in the cage, he was not powerful now. That's why he never tried to terrorize the visitors. The tiger is described as being powerless and agonized by the poet here. He says that in this stanza, that during night even he is alone. When you see, he hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. So in this extract, the poet wants to convey to all the readers that during night even he is alone. He is hearing the voice of the patrolling vehicles of police and looking at the stars. He stares at the shining stars with his shining eyes. Poet wants to say that here, tiger is said. Because he is confined in the cage, so he can't do anything. So that cage has totally changed the tiger's personality. And therefore he stares at the star in the hope, or you can say he tries to divert his thoughts towards them. The poet is trying to say that the animal which is famous for its fearlessness, the tiger which is famous for its power, which is famous for its courage, but for him even freedom is confined, and he became sad due to the human beings who want to derive pleasure by looking at him in the zoo cage. So that's all about this poem. Now the time comes to discuss about some important poetic devices which have been used in this poem. The first one is alliteration. Whenever we see repetition of initial consonant sounds in the same line, then we can say that alliteration has been used here. Repetition of initial consonant sounds. In the very first example, you see he stalks in his vivid stripes. Stalks and stripes. Both words begin with S sound. S consonant sound. So here is alliteration. But he is locked in a concrete cell. Again, concrete cell. C and C. C consonant sound is there. That's why alliteration. The next poetic device is repetition. Repetition. It is a repetition of words, or you can say phrases, in the same line. If we see any word or any phrase used twice in a line, then we can say that repetition has been used here. In the very first example, you see, on pads of velvet quiet, in his quiet rage. In this line, quiet word is used twice here. Same as in the second, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Brilliant word has been used twice in this line. So here we say repetition has been used. The third poetic device is onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is the poetic device whenever we see some words which denote sound. In this poem, you see snarling word. Snarling, that word denotes the sound. So onomatopoeia has been used here. So these are the important things about this poem. Now in the end, we are here to discuss about the rhyme scheme of the poem. So we learn about the rhyme scheme about with the examples there. In the very first stanza, you see that he stalks in his vivid stripes. Stripes, that word in the last word. A, we can give it. The few steps of his cage. Cage, B. On pads of velvet white. C, white, C. In his white rage. Rage, the last word of the fourth line, rage, resembles with the second line last word, cage. So here we give B again. So the rhyme scheme will be A, B, C, B. That's all about this poem. Hope that you all got these all things very well. Hope to see you in the next video. Please subscribe our channel and please press the bell icon as well. And do like and share this video. Thanks for watching. Thanks a lot.